version 0.1. I was at a music conference and met somebody where I said, "So, what are you doing? What are you working on?" And he said, "I am making the ultimate music recommendation engine. This thing is going to be the total enterprise solution that's going to tie into every piece of music you've ever listened to, everything you've ever bought, every concert you've ever gone to, everything in your entire hard drive, and then it's going to connect to all of your friends through all of your social networks and everything they're listening to and every concert they've ever been to and everything, whatever." And he said, "The only problem is I've been trying for 2 years to raise the $2 million it's going to take to make this thing. So, hey, do you know any investors?" I said, "Look, what kind of music would I like?" And he said, "What do you mean?" I said, "You said you want to make a music recommendation service, right? So what kind of music would I like?" And he said, no, man, you don't understand. This is business. This is enterprise. This is going to be big. This isn't just like recommending music to a person. This is like a total back-end solution." I was like, yeah. The problem is that what you're describing here is like everything you ever wanted to be someday. And you know how software has version numbers, right? Like version 1.0, then 2.0 comes out, then 2.5, then version 3.5. So what you've just described here is version infinity. That's like everything it will ever be. Someday in the glorious future, if everything turns out perfectly. But long before that, you've got to start back here at version 0.1. Version 0.1 is the thing that you can do right now, this week, today, with no programming, no nothing, but you can do it now. And then you can just make incremental improvements from that. So I said, in your case, why don't you just recommend a song to somebody or recommend an artist? So you could just turn to anybody here at this conference and say, "Hey, what kind of music do you like?" And they'd say, "I like Bjork." You could say, "Okay, Bjork, what's your name? Write it down. Have you heard Leaky Lee?" "No, I haven't." "Okay, go listen to Leaky Lee and tell me what you think." And there, you've now just made a music recommendation service. And eventually this piece of paper fills up with people you've recommended music to, and maybe they get back to you and tell you what they think. Eventually you could put that into a spreadsheet. Eventually you could put your spreadsheet onto a computer. I mean, online, eventually people could log into their account and ask for recommendations without calling you. Whatever. It sounds so small potatoes, but that's kind of the point. Is that instead of just spending 2 years trying to raise money to do this giant enterprise thing, you can just start. And most importantly, you can start talking to real people that need this thing or not. And then you can know early on whether they need it or not. And then you can start to get their feedback for what they want this service to be. So in my little example at CD Baby, the first version of CD Baby did nothing. It was just a list of CDs, each one with a little add to cart button that would bring you to one of those forms that asks your name and address and credit card info. And my little security secret, by the way, is that for the whole first year, all that form did is email me the info. That's it. I didn't even have any fancy server-side back-end processing. It just sent me an email with all the info. But I would receive each email, and it was only a few a week. I'd highlight my mouse over the name, Control-C, Alt-Tab, Control-V, and I'd paste it into a little form to print out the mailing label and I think a FileMaker Pro database on my computer. And that's it. That's all it did for the whole first year was that. But that was enough to get me profitable in the second month of business. And I think I made something like 100,000 bucks by the end of the year just with that. No programmers, no software, nothing. But it was enough to be to get going, to be in the game. There's a great quote, I think it's from Reid Hoffman. He says, if you're not launching too soon, you're launching too late. Or maybe the quote is something like, if you're not embarrassed by your first version, you've launched too late. The whole point is version 0.1. The thing that you can do right now to get started. You just need this confidence to know that this big massive vision you have for your massive business, it can happen someday, but you have to start now instead of just kind of sitting around trying to raise money and hoping that that might happen someday.